Children, welcome to the online classes of Bishop Academy. And in our last class, we have discussed about the electric potential and potential due to a single charge. And we found that potential due to a single charge is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r. And you know, electrostatic potential is a scalar quantity. That's why whenever two or more than two charges are placed in a surrounding, then the electric potential due to these different charges or multiple charges is the algebraic sum of the total potentials due to individual charge. Why algebraic sum? Because electrostatic potential is a scalar quantity, and scalar quantities are added algebraically. It's okay. And now we have to discuss a problem based on this topic, this formula. It's okay. And now I am reciting the question. Calculate the potential at point P due to a charge of 4 into 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb. Means charge is equals to 4 into 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb, located 9 centimeter away. It means r is equals to 9 centimeter. It means 9 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter. The question is, what is the potential at 9 centimeter from this charge? Then using the above formula, we have the value of 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught is 9 into 10 to the power 9. As you know, q is equals to 4 into 10 to the power minus 7, and r is equals to 9 into 10 to the power minus 2. 9 cancel the 9, and 10 to the power minus 2 is plus 2 when it is taken in numerator, and this is 9 to the power 10 to the power 11. 11 minus 7, 4 into 10 to the power 4 volt. This is the value of potential 9 centimeter away from this charge. This is the application of this formula. And now another one question is added in this problem. Obtain the work done in bringing a charge of 2 into 10 to the power 9 minus 9 coulomb from infinity to the point P. This is the potential at point P, and the question is, what is the work done in bringing 2 into 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb charge at point P from infinity? Yani ki infinity se P point, jiska potential 4 into 10 to the power 4 volt hai, wahan tak lane mein kitna work done karna hoga. It means W is equals to, as you know, according to the definition of potential, V is equals to W by Q. And from here, W is equals to V into Q. V into Q. V is potential. Potential at point P is 4 into 10 to the power 4, calculated earlier. And Q is equals to, the charge which is taken from infinity to that point P is 2 into 10 to the power minus 9. After solving, 4 to the 8 into 10 to the power minus 5 joule. This is the work done in bringing 2 into 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb charge from infinity to the point P. It's okay. The student must solve the above question in your notebook, and the question is provided by me in the Google Classroom. And now we have to discuss electrostatic potential due to an electric dipole. In the previous chapter, we have to calculate electric field due to an electric dipole, and in this chapter we have to calculate electrostatic potential due to electric dipole. It means electric dipole ki wajah se electric potential calculate karna seekhenge. Now consider an electric dipole having length 2L. This is A and B. That's okay. This is point P, r distance from the center of dipole. This is r distance from the center of dipole where electrostatic potential is to be found. Let us consider this is negative charge and this is positive charge. It's okay. This is negative charge and this is positive charge. This is dipole AB and this is the center O. P is the point where electrostatic potential should be found and theta be the inclination from the axis of dipole. It's okay. Now we have to join this A B and P to A, PB and PA. What is our need to find out the potential at point P? The principle of superposition says that first of all we have to find out the potential due to this negative charge at point P and potential due to positive charge at point P, and algebraically sum these potentials. It's okay, because potential is a scalar quantity, then there is no vector sum, it is scalar sum. Then, but a problem is the distance from A to P is not given and the distance from B to P is not given. The formula is potential due to a single charge is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r. The charge is available and we know we have to find the potential at a point, then we need a charge and distance from the charge where potential should be found. We have charge but we do not have the distance from the charge at point P. Then first of all we have to find out this value of PA and PB. It's okay. This is our need. Then we construct a line. We produce this PO such that up to Q, we produce PO up to Q such that AQ is perpendicular to the PQ and AP is approximately equal to PQ. It means APQ is isosceles right angle triangle. Here this angle is theta, then vertically opposite this angle is also theta. It's okay. And the value of OQ is in triangle AOQ, this triangle. This is theta, then AQ is hypotenuse, this is length L because total length of the dipole is L. This is also L. Total length of the dipole is L. Then this is L. This is theta. Then this is hypotenuse. And perpendicular is just L. And base is OQ. Then using cos theta. Cos theta is equals to base upon hypotenuse. Sorry. This is hypotenuse L. Hypotenuse is L. Using cos theta, OQ cos theta is equals to base upon hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is AO. OQ is equals to AO into cos theta and AO equals to L. L cos theta. This is the value of OQ. Now again draw a perpendicular from point B to the line PO, this is R, and assume that PR is approximately equals to PB. In triangle ORB, this is ORB, this is theta, and the side towards the theta is called perpendicular, and side against the perpendicular is hypotenuse. It means OB is hypotenuse and OR is base. Then using cos theta is equals to base is OR and hypotenuse is OB. OR is equals to OB cos theta, and value of OB is L, then it is also L cos theta. It's okay. Now we consider that AP is approximately equals to PQ. This AP is approximately equals to PQ. It's okay. And PQ is written as, PQ is written in two parts, PO plus OQ. PO plus OQ. It's okay. PO is equals to PO. This is R. And OQ is equals to, OQ is equals to L cos theta. This is the value of AP. It's okay. And now, in similar way, the value of PB is equals to, PB is approximately equals to PR. And PR is written as PO minus OR. PO minus OR. We have PR. PU is equals to R minus OR is equals to L cos theta. OR is equals to L cos theta. This is the value of PB. Now our problem is resolved. The value of AP is R plus L cos theta, and the value of PB is R minus L cos theta. These are the two basic problems to find out the potential at point P due to minus Q charge and plus Q charge. Then we have to resolve this problem, and now we have to find out the potential due to these two charges. It's okay. We have PA equals to R plus L cos theta, and PB is equals to R minus L cos theta. These are the two values as we calculated in previous, and now we find out potential at point P due to minus Q charge. Minus Q charge, then V1, it is written as V1. V1 is equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q. Q is minus Q because it is a scalar quantity, and algebraic rules are applied here, upon R. R is distance. Distance means AP. And value of AP is R plus L cos theta. It's okay. This is the potential due to negative charge. It is equation number 1. And now potential due to plus Q charge at point P. Is written as V2, which is equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon distance from positive charge to P is PB, and PB is equals to R minus L cos theta. It's okay. These are the two potentials due to negative charge and positive charge. Now the total potential at point P, the net potential at point P is given by V V is equals to V1 plus V2. Since potentials are scalar quantity, then the net potential is obtained by algebraic sum of equation 1 and 2. It means V1 and V2. There are something common in the both potentials, V1 and V2. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. This is Q, this is Q. First of all, we have to write V2. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, taking common, and Q. These are the common quantity in both. Then taking common, we have 1 upon r minus l cos theta. This is 1 upon r minus l cos theta minus 1 upon r plus l cos theta. In this 1 upon r plus minus 1 upon r plus l cos theta, this is, and this is 1 upon r minus l cos theta. It's okay. Now after solving this, you have to write down this in your original copy. We have, taking LCM of the denominator, V is equals to Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught, and LCM is R minus L cos theta, R plus L cos theta. This is A minus B and this is A plus B. It is written as R square minus L square cos square theta. It's okay. And when this is the multiplication, then R plus L cos theta minus, minus change the sign of this, this is minus R and this is plus L cos theta. It's okay. R cancelled each other and this is L cos theta, 2L cos theta. Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught. 2L cos theta upon R square minus L square cos square theta. It's okay. Now you know Q into 2L is P. This is dipole moment. Then 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q into 2L is P into cos theta upon R square minus L square cos square theta. This is the formula for potential due to a dipole. But when the dipole is short means the length L is smaller in comparison to R. For short dipole, R is greater than L. It means L is very smaller than R. And then neglecting L, in the above expression we have 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught P cos theta upon, neglecting L, we get only R square. This is the formula for potential at point P due to a dipole. It's okay. Due to a short dipole. This is the formula. It's okay. And this is positive when P point is closer to the positive charge, and this potential is negative when point P is closer to the negative charge, because the distance R is short, then the potential is larger. It is inverse relation. It is connected with inverse relation. It's okay. This is the formula for potential due to a short dipole. Now we have to discuss special cases, and special case first is when point P lies along axial direction. Axial direction means point P lies along this direction. then if this is the direction of point P and this lies along axial direction, what is the value of theta? The value of theta along axial line is 0. It means theta is equals to 0. And after putting the value of this theta, we have 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught P cos 0 is equals to 1. Then P into 1 is also P upon R square. This is the formula for potential when point P lies along axial direction. This is the special case. And second case is when point P lies along equatorial direction. When point P lies along equatorial direction, it means perpendicular, then theta is equals to 90 degree. Theta is equals to 90 degree. And after putting the value of cos 90 is equals to 0, then the whole potential is 0. Cos 90 equals to 0, then whole potential is 0. And this is 0 because on the equatorial line, the distance from point A to P and point B to P is equal. And this is negative potential, this is positive potential. After summing this, we get 0 potential. It's okay. Now this class is over, and student must prepare the notes in your classroom copy, previous lecture and this lecture. It's okay.